Hello and welcome. Today we're gonna start creating a level for an Unreal project. I loaded in some assets and created a basic level. Let's see what we can get done. The plan is to create an L-shaped corridor for hopefully a horror game. Let's see how this goes. Feel like this should be taller. So let's do that. Once it's done, is it just done? Interesting. I haven't used Unreal before, so this is going to be a long, long attempt. Let's just pop a cube in here. Move the cube. Two 80 should be a fairly tall cube. Let's give the walls some thickness, 10. Two hundred. even a bit taller, to be honest. Concrete wall sounds horrible, to be honest. What do we have for choice? Heck, let's just do basic wall for now. A wall now. So I create my box, and I can move my box, and that's going to be in my room 1. Access. There we go. Now we have the player boxed in. Perfect. Extra streaming pull over budget. The heck does that mean? Okay, doesn't seem to be really anything important. Interestingly enough, the game fades in from black to white. I assume light must be passing through this somehow then. Cool. Boxed the player in. Everything's collidable. Okie doke, how do we cut something out of this specific wall? So what I'd really like to do is pop a door here. That would be great. Okay, the thickness of this wall is definitely under question. So let's scale this guy in a bit. is so hard to control. Camera speed? Yeah, okay. I think that'll help a bit. Nope, don't want whatever that is. Okay, we need to make a hole in this wall. How the heck to do that? Let's change the texture on this so we can see something else. Perfect. What's the size of this guy? This guy has a scale of 0. Let's give it some depth. Let's give it some width. I wonder if instead I can just take a copy of the door. It on this axis. I did something. Uh-oh. Well, interesting. Not quite what I was hoping for. Definitely not what I was hoping for. Why ever did it do that? Let's just keep on doing. Okay. So what I really needed to do was also this. I'll just pop that here. This and blue. This is the first major success. So we accept this. Where's the No, okay. Still a bit fudgy. So if we take the door and we rotate the door. Can we walk through here? I guess this success hasn't been so successful, seeing as we're probably going to be reusing this door. Oh, I don't like that now. The door wasn't quite on the ground, was it? Okay, how can we get around this? Maybe we can. Change the person? Not a mesh. Okay, so player start. I just scale them? Does that change anything? No. Because that's just a spawner, so that does nothing. How do I get at this guy? Okay, that's a new blueprint. Okay, what I need to do is I need to find player start. Interesting. Could just go with the opposite approach of make the door bigger. Okay, that's a bit better. And now the door. That's not right. Let's turn off all of the snapping. Okay. I have made a cubby hole. What to do in here? For one, let's just reapply all of the snapping. Two, okay, something has vanished on me. Great. What am I not seeing? Oh, cool. I can make the player start somewhere in the middle. Perfect. Disabled something. Oh well. Well, in any case, where was I? Props, static meshes, restroom assets. Perfection. Maybe a smidge higher. No, actually, maybe not. Degrees. Take it in over here. Push it all the way to the edge here. We need possibly two of these. put on the wall. It's going to go on the ceiling anyway. Like the area also needs a lamp. Wonder if I have any in this collection or if I've just deleted it at this point when I was cleaning up the assets. Ooh, okay, there's some other things to possibly populate the world with there. Just make this. Mop, bucket, bog standard cleaning supplies. Do something with them in a second. Get out a radiator. I feel like that would be a fairly common fixture. Let's do that. Alright. Nope. What do we have in here? There's a lamp. Don't think it exactly produces light, but could just put this on the ceiling. Might get creative with that one. Small. Okay, that's kitchen. There's this guy. Nothing here. Or we could just eat a point light out of the plate. Yeah, I don't really think we have any good lights. All right, let's rearrange this stuff anyway. My angle snap back, perfect. Not everything needs to be perfectly lined up. Go, let's take a look now. Think we've created a room that feels fairly alive. Now, just to create a hallway, and then we can start adding some interactivity to it. Make the best asset flip. Okay. Feels like this should be on the ceiling somewhere here. Not the ceiling. Why did I use the word ceiling? Oh god, I'm falling asleep. Plants. Okay, that's overkill.
Maybe like a nice.
Haha. No, I don't think a clock belongs here anyway. Okay. Let's see about this lamp. Can we fudge this into a proper light? First things first, snapping back on. I don't think this will work. But it could. Time to do some sketchy shit, sketchy shit, sketchy shit. Time to do some sketchy, sketchy, sketchy shit. Put that all into the toilet. No. Need to find a better way to sort these models, I think. Okay, let's ignore that for now. So, if I create a cube, I create it in a horrible place. If I move the shrink it a bunch because it's way too big. Now, I want to make this part of the lamp. Perfect. Now, if I shift click on this, I'd go to Boolean. And if I just yep, that is perfect. And then we'll put these through the ceiling. Creates a folder. Lights. Well, that goes into lights. How do I create a little light in Unreal? Point light. Oh, the thing has it in lumens. Interesting. What if we try a different kind of light? So that was a point light. What about a spotlight? That's closer akin to what I want, I think. That is a mad light. Okay, so if I want to rock. Make it like a strength 4. let's give it like a warmer light. Now if I do it perfect, that's much closer to what I want. Hey, Unreal is going interesting. I'm currently building a toilet. I nicked an asset pack from the internet and I've just been realistically having a bit of fun with it. I don't think 3D game dev is much of a my thing, though, so... Let's take this light over here. And then... yeah, I'm going to build a hallway and I'm going to try and make this terrifying, hopefully, somehow. But I think this is probably as good as it gets today. Yeah, I'm starting to wonder if I should be trying to get a character controller with a body. But also, I don't have the time for that, so probably just gonna skip that for this project. Next step is to get this door animating, then to make a hallway that I can walk around, and that's, I think, pretty much it. I do have to say, I think I made a pretty damn good toilet. I feel like everything is a bit too bright in this world, so... Take the skylight and possibly maybe even turn it off. Something to think about. If I were to just turn off both of these lights now. Okay, interesting. I might need to figure out how to get light flickering to work. Unfortunately, I don't think I've covered even remotely a chunk of a spec yet. Let me take a look. Demonstrate the following variables, events, functions. Yeah, there's a lot of code to demonstrate using UI elements, terrain features, importing a, the only thing I've done so far is importing assets. So, long way to go for what is basically, I think, 3 days left now. I'm gonna get some interactivity with the doors going, I think. That's the plan. I think tomorrow is first thing to do is get up the rest of the walls and close and open the door. Okay, let's put the door back into place actually. So all I have to do is just rotate this, right? What's wrong with the rotation snapping? 90. Okay, no idea what I did with the door rotation. Let's turn off snapping and fix that. Well, nobody said it ever had to start at a perfectly closed. There we go. Maybe it should. There. Am I using geometry or manual blocks? Honestly, I don't know the difference. I've been using these boxes from the modeling menu. So I assume it's some form of geometry. But you can enlighten me, to be honest. Should I get this door rotating today? Like, you know what? Maybe that's not a bad idea. Would be nice to have something more than what I have right now. Okay, let's give that a try. Okay. Folder blueprints. What do you mean blueprints already exists? Was it? let's just do that. Okay, so in there's geometry mode and selection mode. As quickly as you can add and subtract blocks, all windows or doorways, etc. Click a cube. So if I click this, okay. So this guy, for example. And then I can edit the cube. I don't think so, unfortunately. Place actors panel. Oh, okay, so I assume I can just make the cube And then put another cube inside of it, and all of a sudden I have a whole room. Is that correct? Cool. And can I take away meshes from these cubes? Like, let's say I wanted to get rid of the doors. Okay, let's give this a try. So let's say I want to make a room that's like 300 by 300 by 300. Oh, I. Okay, let's get rid of this guy. Let's enable clipping because that's nice. So 300 by 300. And now, if I were to create another cube and say it's like 290 by 290 by 290. And if I were to position this to zero and then this to zero. I can then make the second box subtractive. And then inside of this box is empty space. Oh my God. And now I can lift both of them. Up to where my room was originally. Weirdly enough, my room is exactly this size. Can I use the. Okay, so this is nice. We're gonna take this and we're going to put it into walls. Get rid of the ceiling. Cool. Okay, now I can paint these however I want, I assume. If I want to use the basic wall. Perfect. Now for the door, do I need to use another cube or can I just use a door mesh? So if I took a copy of this door mesh, can I subtract that away from the other cube? So let's say I take a copy of the door. And I just stretch it in this direction. Stretch it a bit more. Okay, because I know trying to make a cube just to get rid of the door is bit painful. What if we try, like, maybe it's easier just to make a cube that matches this guy. The scale on the door is different though, isn't that just gonna mess it up? See, something's not right about this. Yeah, that's definitely not right. Maybe if it's yeah, no, that's the big problem. Oh, now I'm fudging with the scale. That's probably not a good thing. Maybe my approach is wrong. Maybe I should be scaling the door to the box. Okay, so now if I this here, get rid of the door, right? Then this is subtractive. Just cool. Okay, I think that's a lot easier to work with. Ever so slightly pull that out, I guess. And now I can just do math tricks to figure this out. Okay. That didn't achieve too much, but at least it's cool. Is there a good place to get some assets? Or materials from somewhere that you'd recommend? Need to go take a look then. Yeah, all of the assets you see here are literally from one of those collections. It's the one, I don't remember what it's called. It's the store props collection. It's actually got some really nice stuff in there. Look at that cute plant. Honestly, you can make so much with literally not much work other than placing objects in the scene. It's mad. Okay, I was gonna try code that door to open up, but it's 11 and I think it's time to probably go to sleep soon. So we'll leave it alone at this today, I think. Oh, is it the mobility one? Movable? Or is it? I assume it's this guy here. Right? I just realized all of the items are ever so slightly underground. Give me a second. Okay, so physics, simulate physics. Simulate physics. trying to simulate physics, but it is at a complex a simple collision. There's an error. It's complaining about something. If only I knew how to do that. Right click. Yes. So now if I do that for this too, that could also be a box. What the heck is a Z simplified? Oh. It looks like it could, yes. I feel like this needs two colliders. Oh, it just keeps stacking them. Remove collision. What would you recommend in a case like this? Capsule probably works best. Are they still physics objects? Did I remove that? Yeah, that'll work here too. Physics. Physics. Simulate physics. All of this is going to tip over on itself, isn't it, when I play? Okay. Probably doesn't help that all of it, none of it is actually in my way. Static mesh accessor. That did not do anything. Probably doesn't help that it's still complaining. Nope. Still just wind up standing on top of it. All right, that's another day problem, I think. Possibly after I actually start coding some stuff. I need to bring this back to a point where I wasn't messing with the collisions. Back now. We'll try. Honestly, this went better than anticipated for day one. All that's really left, I think, is Tuesday and Thursday, and once that's done, it's done. So let's see. It's a good start. Thanks for coming in and helping out. Maybe we'll get the collisions working next time on some smaller object first, and then we'll maybe try to do it everywhere else. See you.